Alright, hello everyone and welcome to the Essex Sport Facebook page. My name's Tracy and I'm going to be taking you through a freestyle fitness yoga session today. So it's going to be about half an hour. Just a few things to run through before we get started. So just need to make sure you've got a nice clear space wherever you are today and that you've got a surface that you're not going to slip on. If you have got a yoga mat then that's ideal, but otherwise just a surface can be comfortable for you standing and moving on and it doesn't feel slippy under your feet as well. As we work our way through, please stop and watch if you need to. Okay, join in again when you're ready, but just make sure you're comfortable with everything that we're working through. Okay, if anything does feel uncomfortable, then please stop, okay, and just listen to what feels comfortable for you as we work our way through. Okay, so when you're ready, we're gonna take a seat just at one end of the mat, if you have a mat. Otherwise, just make sure you've got a nice bit of space in front of you because we're gonna be moving forward to begin with. Okay, but we'll be down on the floor. So I'm just gonna kneel towards one end. If you're comfortable kneeling, then we're going to be just in a comfortable kneeling position. If you'd rather adjust the legs, that's a little bit more comfortable for you, then you can do. What we're going to do from here is just sit nice and tall to begin with. So lifting the chest, bringing the shoulders back and down, and just allowing the arms to relax down by your side. So from here, we're just going to take a few deep breaths, and as you do, just easing the shoulders up and back. So just seeing how that movement feels. Maybe inhale as you lift the shoulders, exhale as you release them back. Alright, lovely. One more time around. And then just reaching the arms overhead. So that next breath, just reaching up. Exhale, bringing the arms wide. And we do that two more times. Deep breath in. And then last one. Perfect. As the arms come down this time, just bring the hands together at the chest. So palms are together. Shoulders just relaxing down away from the ears. Deep breath here. Then as you exhale, just bringing the hands forward, so just turning the palms out. Inhale, lifting overhead. And then as you release, we bring the hands down behind the lower back and just lift the chest, just opening across the front of the chest. And then relaxing the arms down. So we've got one more time through, so shoulder roll, easing up and back. Right, last one, deep breath in, so reaching the arms overhead. Exhale, releasing wide, one more time. Perfect. Right, hands coming together in front of the chest, so palms together, shoulders relaxing away from the ears. Got that deep breath. Exhale, extending forwards. Inhale overhead. And then open the chest, so bringing the hands round behind the lower back. And then releasing there. From here, we're going to move on to all fours, so just moving forwards. You can try to make the shoulders over the wrists, and then the hips just over the knees. Spreading the fingers. So from here, we're just going to round up through the back. So pulling the tummy in and just gently pressing the hands down into the floor. As you return to neutral, we're just exaggerating that arch through the lower back. So lifting the chest and working between the two. Okay, so maybe work with the length of the breath. And just to that point that feels comfortable, we're just really focusing on that mobility through the spine to begin with. One more of each. And then after this last day, just return to a neutral position. From here, we're going to curl the toes under and then just lift the hips that little bit higher. So we're bringing that focus back through the legs. Okay, so again, a little bit of time just to see what feels comfortable here. So feet about hip distance, just spreading the fingers so the weight's even across the hands, across the palms. And a little bit of movement, so just gently alternating one leg to the other, so we're walking through the heels and bending at the knee. Again, rest the knees down any time that you need to, if you just need to ease off for a moment. Otherwise, just take a little time to see how that feels. Then we can just bend both knees, okay, to the chest, just a little bit closer to the thighs, and then extending through the legs again. So just see what feels comfortable for you. Lovely. From here, rest the knees down, so coming onto all fours. I'm going to drop the hips back, so flexing, bringing the chest forwards, arms extended out in front. And just pausing here for a moment, so nice stretch through, spread the fingers wide, press the hands down into the mat. Okay. Okay, from here, bringing the weight forward, so we're going to come over the hands, and you can either have this nicely supported, so we've got the knees down, but we're just engaging through the core. If you're happy to, though, I'm going to come onto the toes, so we're in a more elevated plank position. And we're just pausing in either of those positions for a moment. So steady breaths. Try and lift up through the upper body so we're not collapsing and allowing the head to drop towards the shoulders. Perfect. And knees are resting down if they're not already. Got two movements that we're going to combine here. So we've got a dip, bringing the chest towards the mat, and then dropping the hips back. So you're going to work between the two. As the weight comes forwards, elbows close to the body, bring the chest low, and then sit the hips back again. So in your own time, and if you're not comfortable with that dip that feels too much through the arms or the wrists, hold that plank position for a moment, and then sit back. So you've got a bit of choice there. Either way, let's have two more of each. So low, sit back. Right, final time, whichever one of those you're doing. And then dropping the hips back, chest low to the floor again. And just walking the hands in, so we'll just return into that seated position where we started. So we're going to start right from the beginning. So just take a moment and wriggle it comfortable if you need to. And then just lift the chest, bring the shoulders back and down for that shoulder roll to start with. So inhale, lifting the shoulders towards the ears. All right, perfect. Deep breath in, arms overhead this time. So all the way up, big release, bringing the arms out to the side. Two more. Lovely. Right, hands together at the chest, so shoulders relaxing, palms together, deep breath. As you exhale, just extending the arms forward, inhale overhead, and release into our chest stretch. So hands down behind the lower back, lift the chest or the shoulders back, and then release it. Onto all fours, moving the shoulders over the wrists, knees in line with the hips. And then for that mobility, that focus through the spine. So just inhale, just lifting. And then as you exhale, pulling the tummy in, gently pressing the hands down towards the floor. Again, just working between the two. Right, we'll do one more of each. And then we turn into neutral again, just after that last time. Curl the toes under. So the same few steps we did before. And lifting the hips high and bringing the focus back through the legs. Get this a little bit of time, just adjusting the hands, the feet as you need to. Weight either between the two hands. And we've got that movement, so just alternating, bending each knee, just gently walking down through the heels. Again, see what feels comfortable for you. If you need to drop down onto all fours again, you can do. A slow, steady breath here as well. Keep breathing, let's hold the breath at all. Lovely. When you're ready to, dropping the knees down, and we're just going to sit the hips back. So chest moving low to the floor. And for that moment, just to pause again. So you can spread the fingers. And so we've brought the weight forward. So into our plank position. So shoulders are over the wrists. Okay, we keep that supported. So we've got the knees down. And we come up onto the toes. And we'll just pause it here for a moment. So think about that strength through the upper body. There's a long line running through the body. Try not to let the neck collapse towards the shoulders, so strong through the arms, through the shoulder area. And rest the knees down. One dip, one sit back to the heels. So just flex of the elbows are close to the body, and then sit the hips back. Remember, if you don't want to do that press at the front, you can just hold plank, and then drop the hips back. So one more of each. Again, slowly walking the hands in when you're ready to, and just returning to that seated position. So just for a moment, we're going to bring the focus to the hips. So from here, we're going to step one foot forwards, okay, either side. As you do, just be aware of how that stretch feels around the hip area. So you can adjust the stance if you need to. But that front knee is over the ankle. And once you're happy there, chest is facing forwards, arms extended up overhead. So we're going to pause here for a moment. As you inhale, just about reaching right through to the fingers, drawing the shoulder blades down away from the ears. Weights even between the two feet. Perfect. We're going to keep the legs as they are. We're just going to take a bend through the elbows. So we're taking a 90 degree bend. I'll show you there. So bending at the elbows, spreading the fingers wide. And try to draw the elbows back so you can just feel that opening through the chest, across the front of the shoulders. And release. Let's try the same on the other side. So stepping back tighter than the other, so you can just change that there and start through the legs if you need to. Otherwise, chest facing forwards, knees over the ankle, arms extended up overhead. So reach through to the fingers, draw the shoulders blade down away from the ears. Deep breath punch up here. So put that same movement through the arms again. So spread the fingers wide, just flexing at the elbows, and drawing the elbows back. So again, just put that opening through the chest. Just show you again, slight turn there so you can see that bend of the elbows. And release. Right hand to either side, come back. From here, we want to stand in slowly. So we're just going to slowly come onto the feet to begin with. So onto the balls of the feet, and just extending through the legs. Okay, so see how this feels for you. It might be able to keep that slight bend in the knees. See what feels comfortable. I'm going to very slowly roll up to stand in. So take your time, head, the shoulders coming up last, and then all the way up. Okay, I'm going to turn to face you. So we're going to come back to that same movement we did through the arms to begin with. So just bring the hands together at the chest. Deep breath. Exhale, extending forwards. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Shoulder roll. Up to the ears. Hopefully those shoulders have been a little bit looser than they were at the start. One more time round. Perfect. Arms overhead, deep breath, all the way up. And release. Lovely. So the first part now, we're on our feet, is going to be a little bit more balanced. So have a look at your floor, and okay, bear that in mind as we work through. If your mat's quite spongy, you might want to step onto a half floor, that might be more comfortable. If your floor's particularly comfy, then you might find that you just want to be next to a wall if you have that space. But think about that as we work through, and just make sure you kind of feel comfortable with the balance and the lift as we go. Nothing too extreme with. So first of all, we're just going to take the weight onto one leg, so it's just a small lift. Think about that supporting leg, okay, so we've got our strong base, we're lifting through the thigh, and we're going to just draw the knee up, so we'll show you that from the side, knees level with the hip. Okay, keep the hands on the hips, okay, if you need to, touch that toe down at any time. I'm just think about how that balance feels to begin with, okay, if it's quite comfortable for you, or maybe that floor is making it slightly more challenging. If you're happy to, the arms are then just going to reach up overhead. Remember that supporting leg lifting through the thigh, through the core. We can run that attention then right through to the fingers. Good. Lovely. Place the foot down any time if you need to, and just join in again when you're ready. But all we can do for now is just extend that leg forwards. There's a little bit of space in front. Palms just pressing out to the side. And place that foot down. So we go on the other side. Okay, see if that feels the same for the other side as well. So put that supporting leg. And then when you're ready, so you just lift in the knee. Okay, so knees in line with the hip. We can pop it down if we need to at any point. Hands either on the hips or reaching up overhead. So again, we've got that long line all the way through the body. And we're just finding that point to focus on, so that can just really help that balance as well. Good. Leg just extending forward. It doesn't have to be high, but we're just getting that length through the leg as well. And then placing that down. Good, we've got a little bit to add to that. If that was enough for you, then that's what we're gonna stay with. Okay, and we're just focusing on that control. Might be one side was a little bit easier than the other, so just bear that in mind. And then just adapt to a level you're comfortable with as well. Okay, so come back to that first side there. So we're just lifting the knee, finding the focus, reaching the arms up overhead. Pause in there. Lovely. Extending that leg forwards. Now what we've got the option of here is just very slightly bringing that leg behind. So it's not a big lift, not a big movement. You just find that pivot point of the hip. So the chest, just leaning forward slightly, reach the fingers behind, and then we turn it back to standing. Let's work through the same on the other side. So we've got that knee lift, knee raise to begin with, lifting through the supporting leg, and then extending through the arms. So you're gonna find that point to focus on, and then leg just extending forwards. Good. And that same movement. So our pivot point, just going from the hip of that supporting leg. Hold it there. Right, we turn it to standing, perfect. Right, a little bit of everything through the hips. So we're gonna come back to that. All we need for now is just bring the knee across the body and then out to the side. So we're focusing that movement through the hip joints. Okay, so the same on the other side as well. Right, lovely. One more time. And then just bring the feet back to the center. Okay, what we're doing from here is we're gonna start just at the front of the mat or the front of your space. So you've got a little bit of room to step back. We're gonna move forwards. And one foot's going to step back, and as you do, you're just going to open that hip slightly, so the foot's just turning out to the side. Okay, that front foot's facing forward still, and then just flex the knee on the front leg, so knees over the ankle. Once you're happy with that, put the chest facing forwards, past those toes in front, and then arms lifting over the head. Okay, pause there so we'll look. So knees over the ankle, that front leg, chest is lifted, but the weight is even between the 2 feet. Okay, so we're pressing down into the mat. And if that feels at all tight around the hips, take the feet a little bit wider if you need to, and just get that comfortable base through the legs before you go anywhere else. Okay, what we're going to do from here, we're going to release the arms. They're coming down by your side, and then just drawing the chest forward. So it doesn't have to be a big movement, but we're reaching the fingers behind, so shoulders are coming away from the ears. Good, arms sweeping up, so that's where we started, arms overhead. Right, watch this back leg. So we're just going to have a small pivot round into the ball of the foot, so hips are square, and then stepping the feet in. Do the same on the other side. I'm going to turn around so I'm still facing you. You can stay where you are. So make sure it's that other leg stepping back this time. So step back, open the hips. So again, that foot's just turning out to the side, flexing the knee on that front leg. Chest is facing forwards, arms reaching overhead. Pause in there. So again, how does that feel? Does that sound a little tighter? Does it feel okay? Can you take the feet wider? Please do. Nice, a couple of deep breaths on you there. So that same movement through the upper body, through the arms. So arms just release into the side. And then let the chest draw forward. Draw forwards. So fingers are reaching behind. On that long line from the heel all the way through to the top of the head. Right. Sweeping the arms up. And then that same movement through the back legs. We're going to pivot round. So onto the ball of the foot. Bring that hip square. And then big step in. Reach up. Right, stay where you are. Let's go a little warmer. So toes are facing forwards. What we do from here, we're going to flex at the knees, flex at the hips. And as you do, you're just anchoring the hips back. So the weight's in the heels, pushing the bottom back behind, arms reaching overhead if they're comfortable there. So how low you go here is very much depending on how that feels. And just finding that position that feels comfortable. Give the legs warming up a little bit though. And then coming back to standing. As you release the arms, we're going to flex forward at the hips. Okay, so coming maybe halfway down, if it's comfortable to, a little bit further. Again, if you need to soften the knees, maybe take a slight bend through the knees, you can do. And we're rolling back up to standing. So slowly up. As we reach the top, the arms are going to come all the way around, full circle, and then come back down by your side. Let's do that again. So flex at the knees, the hips, pushing the hips back, just the weight down through the heels. And then try to get the chest lifted so that focus straight ahead. Pressing into the mat, come up to standing. Deep breath, as you exhale, hinging forwards, we're bringing the chest forwards, halfway or all the way down. And then that slow rise to your curl, come back to standing. Fantastic, big circle around the arms, and bringing them down by your side. Right, let's put a few of those steps together then. So we're coming right back to where we started, we've got our knee raised. And we've got a little bit of balance work, so we'll step back into our standing sequence. So if you get lost at all, please stop, watch, join in again when you're ready to, but really take your time as you step from one bit to the next, okay? So we're going to stand either at the front of your mat or the front of your space, depending on where you are at home. Chest lifted, get a nice tall posture to begin with, arms down by your side. Deep breath, okay. So we're going to take the arms up and over to begin with. Nice deep breath, reaching up, exhale, and release. Right, one side we start on, so whichever leg you're going to start with, just lifting, maybe the knees level with the hip if that's okay, and then arms are reaching up overhead. Perfect. Now you can stay there, you don't have to move at all. If you're happy to, that leg's extending forwards, we're just pressing the palms out to the side. From here, the leg moves behind, so it's still a shift with that weight there, so chest ever so slightly moving forwards. Again, it can be a very small movement. Lovely. Right, we turn the feet. We're going to step that same foot back, so stepping back. Foot's just turning out, so we're opening through the hip, and then chest facing forwards. Again, take your time. Let's get these feet in a comfortable position. And once you're there, arms reaching overhead. Deep breath. Perfect. Right, arms down by your side. And that movement, just drawing the chest forwards, fingers reaching behind. Good. Sweeping the arms up there. Deep breath. Once we have that little pivot round from the back foot, so we're squaring the hips. Probably been a little more of a stretch through the front of the hip there as well. Big step in, bring the feet together. Right, lowering the legs, we've just done this bit. So we're gonna flex at the knees, the hips. Anchor the hips back, press down through the heels. So just pause in here. then exhale, hinging forwards. Okay, so moving the chest forward either halfway or all the way down. Lovely. Hold it there, okay, a little bend through the knees if you need to. Slowly uncurling, so just return into standing. Big circle through the arms, all the way around. And then just reset the shoulders, roll them back and down. So we're going to do the same on the other side. Okay, so one leg you have done, we're moving on to the other leg now. So deep breath to begin with, deep breath in. And release. Whichever side you haven't done, let's have that knee raise. Okay, so chest is lifted, knees may be level with the hip, arms reaching overhead. Deep breath. Good, okay, so with that movement, if you're happy to, we're extending that leg forward. So I lost my foot off the screen, then my leg's extended. And then just drawing that behind, okay, so that focus point, that pivot point is at the hip, as we just bring the chest forward slightly. Good, returning to standing. Step back. I'm going to turn around all the three faces. We're going to step the other foot back, open the hip, and then flex the knee on that front leg. Chest is facing forward, arms extending overhead. Deep breath. And release. So I draw the chest forward then, shoulders away from the ears. Hold it there. And then arms sweeping up. All the way up. Good. So that pivot round then on the back foot. Let the hips square. Again, maybe to roll that stretch a little bit more through the front of the hip now. Big step in. Right, lower the legs. How are we doing? These legs are kind of a little bit warmer. So anchor the hips back. Press down through the heels. And then pushing up to standing. All the way forward. We're going to exhale. Then flex forward. Bring maybe the fingertips down towards the floor. See how that feels. And then slowly uncurling. So come all the way back up. And then a bit shoulder roll. Bring the arms all the way around. Right, come into the centre. We're going to do a nice movement just to help loosen off a little bit more, and then we're going to work through that sequence one more time. Okay, so this is the feet back hip distance. So coming to this angle out slightly. Deep breath in. As you exhale, we're just going to sweep down towards the floor. So bend the knees just as low as you're comfortable to, but nice big movement this one. So really nice bit of energy. Work with the length of the breath. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Let's do that one more time. Right, fantastic. And release. Could bring that a little closer, but the stretch is here. So we're moving one hand into the other, reach up overhead, and our stretch is going to focus along the side of the body. So we're just going to press the hands off to one side. As you do, try to push the opposite foot into the floor. So I'm reaching to my left, so my right foot's going to be pressing down just a little bit more into the floor. Just feel that stretch a little bit more as well then. Into the centre, into the other side. And release. Perfect. Right. Final time through, and then we're just returning back down to the floor. Okay, so with that balance, feel quite comfortable with that balance. Then if you want to, as we lean forwards, we can maybe take it a little bit more challenging, so we've got a slightly bigger angle. Okay, if you're still quite new to it, or it just isn't appropriate in your situation at home, then just maybe we keep that movement a little bit more controlled, a little bit smaller, to use the space that you have. When we come into our low position, so when we're down here, angling the hips back, you want a little bit of an extra challenge there through the legs for your balance. And we've got the option of just lifting those heels if you want to as well. But again, see how you're finding it, and see how it feels for you at home. Okay, last time through then. So we're going to come back to the front of the mat, and just lift the chest so the shoulders wriggle. Find that comfortable position to begin with. Right, deep breath in, arms up and over. So that first side, knee raise, find that point to focus on, arms extended. Legs extended in front, and then taking that movement behind. So remember that pivot point to the hip. And we can keep it small, or if you're happy to, we can bring that chest a little bit further forwards. And release, come back up to standing. That same foot stepping back. So we're going to open the hip, flex the knee, so the knee's over the ankle, chest facing forwards, arms lifted, pause in there. Release, draw the chest forwards, reach the fingers behind, and then sweep it back up. Good, so that little movement through the back foot, so we're pivoting, we're coming onto the ball of the foot, big step in, lower the legs, so we have just done this, but push the hips back, reach the fingers up. If you want to, put that little added option, we're coming onto the balls of the feet, so we're lifting the heels, but yeah, totally optional, that. We'll see how you find it. Heels can be placed down anyway. Make the legs that little bit warmer quite quickly. Heels down, Hinging forwards then, so forward fold. Halfway all the way down. And then slowly uncurling as we come back up. So that full circle round with the arms, big circle. Reset the shoulders. Final side to go. I'm going to switch sides now, so I'm on the right side for you. Right, deep breath when you're ready. Arms up overhead. And release. Right, knee raised then, so that final side to go. Legs extending, arms pushing out to the side. Okay, so bring that leg behind there, so just bringing the chest forwards. Again, that strong supporting leg. So we're lifting up through the thigh. And release, stepping back. Open the hip. Okay, so open the hip on that back leg. Flex the knees over the ankle, chest lifted. Pause in there. And release, draw the chest forwards. Reach the fingers behind. And then sweeping the arms back up. Pause in there, good. Lovely, so that little movement then through the back hips. So we're going to pivot round, okay, onto the ball of the foot. And then big step in. Lovely, loving the legs, so push the hips back. Right, if you want to, we're lifting the heels, so last time. And when you're ready to, heels down, push up to standing, hinging forwards, okay, so hinging forwards, halfway, all the way down. And then slowly uncurling as we come back up. Big circle around the arms all the way through. And then reset the shoulders. Right, fantastic. Hopefully you found that okay. Okay, a little bit warmer, a little bit looser than when we started. If you need to, grab a quick drink, okay? And then as soon as you're ready to, just come back and take a seat on the mat, and we're just gonna finish up down on the floor, okay? Right, perfect. Right, so we're gonna work it out. See, because we did right at the start, we're just gonna go through that once, and then we'll slow it right down for our last couple of minutes. Okay, so if you're happy kneeling, we're back to kneeling. And if you want to adjust the legs, so it's a little bit more comfortable, then you can do. Okay. Right, otherwise chest lifted. Ease the shoulders up and back. Hopefully they're a little bit looser than when we started now. One more time. Right, deep breath in. So the arms overhead. Exhale, release. Into our chest stretch. So we're bringing the hands round behind. Lift the chest, draw the shoulders back. And release. Onto all fours. It's just lining the knees under the hips, fingers are spread wide. And then we're just going to lift the chest for that mobility, that focus, just through the spine again for a moment. And using the length of the breath, so we're just working with whatever length of movement feels comfortable for you. Right, after that, let's go. Just return to neutral, curl the toes under, lifting the hips up. So that focus again, just moving back through the legs. And then pause in here. Okay, we come back to that movement if you want to, we did at the start. Okay, if you're happy just holding that position steady, then you can do, okay? Again, fingers are spread wide, nice even between the two hands. Couple of deep breaths here. Right, lovely. Drop the knees down, so we're coming down to all fours again. Hips back, so arms are extended in front, chest low to the floor. And then from here, bringing the weight forward. So if you remember this from earlier on, shoulders over the wrists. We've got one press, and just one sit back, so dropping the hips back. Then we can do that two more times. If you don't want to do that press, what we can do is just draw the weight forwards. Last one there. And from here, just walking the hands in, just returning to seated. I'm going to take a seat just in the centre of the mat, so just wherever you're comfortable so you can see for this last little bit. I'm going to cross my legs, you can cross your legs if you want to. If you're happy with the legs extended, that's fine as well. I'm just going to bring a little bit of attention to the arms for now. So one arm just reaching across, so that stretch around the side of the shoulder. Lovely, pause in there. And then we're going to stay on the same side. shoulder. I'm gently just extending the elbow up towards the ceiling. So let's stretch just through the triceps. Pause in there. So we stay on the same side. So as you release this arm, just bring that hand down to the floor, lifting through the center, and then reaching across. This time we've got that stretch along the side of the body. And release. Right, same on the other side. So the arm's just reaching across the chest with that stretch. Again, just around the outside of the shoulder. Pause in there. Lovely. Right, so same again, hands towards the shoulders, gently extending the elbow up. Right, good. This hand's coming down to the floor, so reaching down, lifting through the center, and then extending across. Good, just trying to get that stretch on the side of the body. Releasing when you need to. Right, bring the hands together. Inhale, as you release. Extending forwards, lifting in the center. Exhale, taking the arms wide. Do that one more time. Right, perfect. From here, we're just coming to a forward fold. So if you're showing from the side, you can keep the legs bent if you want to, or you'd rather do this with the legs extended, then you can do as well. All we're going to do is just bring the hands, just the fingertips are touching the floor. Just very gently, just ease the chest forward slightly. It might be there's a very small movement, and that's fine. You want to stay there. You might find you're comfortable just moving that a little bit closer to the floor. Okay, you decide. You need to ease off completely at any point, that's fine as well. Okay, well, so just pausing wherever you're happy to, and just with a couple of steady breaths there. Walking the hands back and coming back up to seated. Okay, just the last little bit then, we're just going to rest the hands down into your lap. Okay, and just allow the gaze to drop down to the floor. And if you want to, you can close your eyes, but otherwise we're just keeping that gaze down and the shoulders to relax. And just taking a few slow, steady breaths just before we finish. You want to, you can maybe just rest the hands just gently to the side of the tummy. So then you can just feel the rise and fall with each breath as well. And just resting the hands back into the lap. If you have had the eyes closed, just allow the eyes to open while we're still looking down towards the floor. And then lifting the gaze again when you're ready to. Okay, ease the shoulders round. And we've got one deep breath to finish with. So arms up overhead. And then releasing out to the side. Right, pause in there, well done. Okay, we'll come a little bit closer just before we finish. Right, thank you so much for joining me today. Okay, I hope you found the session enjoyable. Okay, any questions at all, please just message into the Essex Sport Facebook page and one of our team can get back to you and answer any questions that you do have. We've got a series of Facebook classes running this week, so they're all at lunchtime, and they are Monday, Wednesday and Friday, they are 12 o'clock, and then Tuesday and Thursday, they are 12:30. So have a look at the Facebook page, see what we've got coming up. Again, any questions, please message in, and one of us will get back to you. But thank you so much, enjoy the rest of your afternoon, and hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.